Today, let's do the coolest limit on YouTube. We have the limit as x approaching infinity of ln x over the Lambert W function of x. And you might be wondering, what's the Lambert W function? Don't worry, I'm going to give you guys a quick review. But before I do that, let me just tell you guys the answer right away. The answer is equal to 0 factorial. I'm sorry. The answer is just equal to 1. And this is really, really cool because it shows that the Lambert W function and natural log of x, they are approximately the same as x gets to infinity. Yeah? Alright, so I'm going to show you guys a quick review for the Lambert W function. But before that, let's draw some connection with the ln x. Here, if we start with a function e to the x, well, the inverse function is precisely ln x. The n stands for natural, and the l stands for log. So in another word, this is the natural log function. Now, the Lambert W function is also an inverse of some function. And that function is, not only we have e to the x, but we multiply the x right here. Once we have this, the inverse of x times e to the x is precisely the Lambert W function. Lambert is a name of a person, and in fact, for this right here, it's also a logarithm function. This is the product log. I think the word product is because this is the product of x and e to the x. So this is defined to be the inverse for that. And now let's investigate a little bit, because the first little question is, we need to know what's the limit as x approaching infinity of the Lambert W function. Okay, so this is how I'm going to do it. I'm just going to tell you guys that for this right here, it's now a one-to-one function. In order to have a one-to-one function, we have to find the minimum and then just cut it. And then I will tell you though, the domain to have inverse. So just domain to have inverse. The minimum, if you do the derivative, is x times e to the x plus e to the x, and you just set the equal to 0, so you can find the critical number. E to the x times x plus 1, it's equal to 0, and that won't give you 0. This right here, it's x equal to negative 1, so that's the critical number. So if you take the derivative, you get that, and if you draw a number line, negative 1, put a number less than negative 1, let's say negative 2, you will see a negative derivative. And then after negative 1, you will see positive derivative. So the minimum, in fact, the absolute minimum, happens when x is at negative 1. So the domain is at starting at negative 1, and you go to infinity. Again, this is the domain to have inverse. Then we'll see the range. The range of this thing is just the minimum value. You plug in negative 1 to here, you get negative e to the negative 1, so let's write it as 1 over e. And as x goes to infinity, let's just take a quick look of this function, x times e to the x. This is clearly going to give you infinity. Yeah. So we have this to infinity. So that's the range for that. And the reason that we talk about the domain range is because now, to talk about this, well, the domain and the range, it's just you put this range right here for the domain, and then you put the domain right here for the range. X and y get switched, right? So the domain is negative 1 over e to infinity, and the range is negative 1 to infinity. And because we know the range gets to infinity, I think this right here is pretty clear now that if we have the limit as x approaching infinity of the Lambert W function, we know the answer will be infinity. This right here should be pretty good. And how do we show the limit though? Of course, Mr. L'Hopital, because ln of infinity is infinity, w of infinity is also infinity. So in fact, this is an infinity over infinity case. We can use L'Hopital's rule. So right here, let's go ahead and take the derivative. Likewise, on the bottom, And that will be the limit as x approaching infinity. The top is nice, it's just 1 over x. But how about the bottom? We have to do the derivative right here. How though? Here is the deal. I'm going to say y is equal to the Lambert W function of x. I cannot take the derivative right here, but I do know the inverse of the Lambert W function. So if I apply the inverse on both sides, here we will get y e to the y equals x. Why is this? Let me just work backwards so it's more clear. Imagine we have this equation and we just take the Lambert W function. Because this and that match and we have the e, Lambert W function of y e to the y will just get the y back, and then we have the Lambert W function. So it's kind of like we're doing this backwards. From y equals this, we get this. Why do we need this though? Because now we can do implicit differentiation. So ddx, here, we need a product rule. So I will keep the first function times the derivative of the second, which we have e to the y, and use the chain rule, the derivative of y with respect to x is dy dx. And then we add the second function times the derivative of the first, which is dy dx, and that's equal to 1. Now, we can factor out the dy dx, and let me just write y e to the y plus e to the y, and then we have the dy dx, that's equal to 1. We can just divide this to both sides, so we get dy dx equals 1 over y e to the y plus e to the y. Good, but this is not that useful because I need to have things in terms of x to work with this limit, right? But don't worry, have a look. Y e to the y is x. So we have 1 over x plus e to the y. Okay, we can look at this equation and divide the y to both sides. So we can say e to the y is equal to x over y. But what's y? Y is the Lambert W function of x. So e to the y equals x over w of x. So for this y is x over the Lambert W function of x. Right here, I'm just going to multiply the top and bottom by the Lambert W function of x. Surprise, I have a green pen. W of x here, and then W of x here. And the result of that is precisely our derivative. And let me put that down right here. Here, the top is just W of x over distribute, but I'm going to factor out an x first, like this. All right, so I will have W of x times 1, which is just W of x, plus this and that cancel, we get 1, and the x is out already. So the green part is the derivative of the Lambert W function of x. This is actually really nice, because now what? Look, here we have the little x on the bottom, likewise that, we can multiply the top and bottom by x. So this and that cancel right away. And then we can put this bottom thing to the top. So we get the limit as x approaching infinity of w of x plus 1 over w of x. Now, it depends on how you would like to do it. You can split the fraction and you get 1 plus 1 over w of x. And remember, w of x is going to give you 0 as x goes to infinity. Another way to do it is just you compare this and that. The one doesn't matter. So finally, you see that the answer is just equal to 1. Alright, note. Here we can write ln x being approximately the same as the Lambert W function of x as x gets to infinity. And I think this is really, really cool.